till I'm good and done. I'm gonna push it hard. I was made for this.
Hello and welcome to the Women's SUNY Plattsburgh Hockey Pre-Show. I'm Jeffrey Koff, and today we're getting ready for the Plattsburgh Cardinals to take on the Potsdam Bears. Now, this is a rematch from last night's game where the Cardinals were able to come away with an 8-3 victory over the Bears. In that victory, the Cardinals were able to continue their winning streak and bump their record up to 18-2-1 as the women's team maintains their number two spot in the conference. Let's take a look at some of last night's highlights. The first player we want to highlight is Annie Katanka. It's hard to not talk about her this season. She's going into this game with 2 goals and 1 assist. Those 2 goals were on power plays. Katanka now has 28 power play goals during her career, on top of her 150th career achievement and being named NWHL Player of the Week twice this season. Be sure to keep an eye out for Annie. Moving forward, Nicole Unsworth had a great game last night. 2 goals and 3 assists. Nicole earned 5 points last game. Definitely a strong player to keep an eye on. Number 18, May Olshansky, had a great game, scoring 2 goals. The sophomore forward is proving herself to being able to push down in the opposing team's side and score. Last SUNY-Potsdam matchup on December 3rd, Olshansky also scored a goal. Hopefully today we'll see another from her. But last, and certainly not least, is your Plattsburgh Cardinal goaltender, Chloe Beaubien, having a fantastic save average of 0.922, only letting in 3 goals during the entire game. Beaubien didn't see much action down on her end, but was able to defend the goal well when Potsdam made it over to the Plattsburgh goal during the second half. Let's take a look at some of the other player stats for both the Cardinals and the Bears. For the Cardinals, their top forward, Sarah Kosnek, had 1 assist last night and overall has scored 39 points, 14 of which being goals. Then again, Annie Katanka, the grad student, has scored 37 points this season, with 21 coming off of goals, 2 of which were last night, including an assist.
Can I get the logo in the full screen in the background if you can? Yeah. You can go back to the graphics.
Yeah, I can't pull them both up.
Just keep talking.
Okay, last night the men's team also faced off against Potsdam as the Cardinals were looking for the sweep both in Potsdam and in Plattsburgh against the Bears. We'll check back with their scores throughout this game. Some of our students went there on a bear hunt last night, and they were not disappointed with that outcome as the men's team took home a 5-2 victory against the Bears. Some outstanding players were Hogg, who opened the scoring at 6:16 of the first period with his first goal of the season, ripping a time shot past the goaltender from the high slot off a feed from Mancuso. The Cardinals took a 3-1 advantage at 6:22 of the second period with Carson Gallagher's goal scored on the power play. Mancuso dropped a pass off for the senior defenseman, Matt Arugio, on the back point, and Arugio sent the puck towards the slot that got caught up in traffic before Gallagher deflected it in. Looking outside college hockey, the Winter Olympics have had the eye of the games. The American women's hockey team is looking to take home their second gold medal. During the 2018 games, America took home the gold. Hillary Knight and Kendall Cohn Schofield had returned for the 2022 Olympics. The women's team started out strong, winning three games back-to-back this past Tuesday, February 8th. Then the women lost to Canada 2-4. However, the team made a comeback earlier today during the quarterfinal playoffs. The U.S. won 4-1 against the Czech Republic Monday, February 14th. On Monday, February 14th, the women will continue to the semifinals. In more Olympic news, the women's Canadian team played their full game in KN95 masks. We saw during the summer and at the start of the Winter Olympics, the athletes performed without masks. However, an hour before the game against Russia, Olympic Committee, it was reported that Rock didn't have... not provide COVID-19 test results. Both teams decided to play in KN95 masks. The Canadian team came out on top 6-1. Moving back towards the Cardinal hockey, we have an incredible matchup for you tonight against the Potsdam Bears. So we're going to throw it over to the field house now, where Liam Sample will be over there for the call of the game. Let's get excited for some Cardinal hockey, and let's do that hockey. Liam?
We're going to do a replay, just improv if you can.
Okay, I can't see it, though. All right. Well, before the game starts tonight, we're going to look at some highlights from last night and just go over what made that game so special. Early on, the Cardinals went up to a 5-0 lead, in part thanks to their second line. We had some big performers last night from them, including multiple goals from the second line, although they weren't the only stars of the show, as the first line also made some noise, as the captain, who we always seem to talk about, Annie Katanka, managed to find the back of the goal as well. Potsdam did manage to mount somewhat of a comeback in the second period, though, as they were able to put up a goal, one of which being on a power play, the other being on a breakaway from a Potsdam player. Plattsburgh, though, ever relentless, did not take their foot off the gas, as they were able to come back in the third period and put up three more goals, being able to put the Potsdam Bears away 8-3 last night. And we'll try and see a repeat of that tonight. Plattsburgh, since 2008, is 32-0 against these Potsdam Bears, so they'll look to make it 33 as the Bears look to finally break through against this Cardinal team that many teams haven't been able to. Recently, they've gone 13-0-1, with their only blip on the radar being a tie against the Cortland Red Dragons, who they managed to beat the very next day. So Potsdam looking to break through a little bit, as no team has been able to do, but if it will be anything like last night, the Cardinals are going to play hard for a full 60 minutes, and with a team with this much talent, it's going to be hard to beat no matter who you are. Continuing on, the Cardinals managed to get that win against the Bears by having a great offensive showing, as they managed to spend most of the time in the game in their offensive zone, keeping the pressure on Potsdam, and despite some great goalie play, they were able to break through as they nearly doubled the Potsdam shots on goal, and just an incredible job for the game. So we'll look for a repeat of that tonight as we head back to the Stafford Ice Arena for some more Cardinal hockey here on PSTV.
Test. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Cardinal. To Ronald E. Stafford Ice Arena. It's an interesting one here today. Second straight game for the Cardinals versus the Bears. Plattsburgh trounced the Bears yesterday, winning 8-3. Yesterday's 8-3 win for the Cardinals against Potsdam included a five goal first period, and then throughout the entire game we saw two from May Olshansky, the sophomore, two from the grad student Annie Katanka and the captain, and two from Nicole Unsworth. This allowed Plattsburgh move to 18-2-1 this year with a 13-0-1 conference record, allowing them to clinch the top spot in the division. That's their fourth straight year winning the Newell, and they have won it every year since the conference came into existence. Astor Potsdam moved down to 8-12-1 overall, the 6-8-1 conference record, and is barely hanging on to that final playoff spot in the conference. They currently have that 2-point lead on SUNY Canton. It'll be interesting to see how this one goes tonight. Yesterday, Plattsburgh got 5-0 after the first, like mentioned. Then Potsdam able to score two in that second, trying to almost get back into it. It was a little bit of one of the weaker periods for the Cards this season. And then after the third, it was back like in their dominant ways, scoring three in that period. When I spoke with a couple different players on the team, it was all very similar to that. It wasn't the greatest game they played, including that second period, but ended up getting that win at the end of the day. That's something Annie Katanka talked about. And when I actually spoke with goaltender Ashley Davis, another thing she mentioned to me is trying to play a more consistent game, get all 60 minutes of ice hockey. So we'll see if they can do that today as Ivy Borg takes this one on the far side. Quick shot save made. Rebound loose. Sarah Krosnick almost able to get a first goal. Tonight, for the second night in a row, it's Ellie Zerflu. She made 31 saves yesterday with 8 goals allowed, got absolutely peppered throughout the entire game, but stood her ground and made a lot of nice stops, but of course allowed 8, and there were a lot of plays where she was kind of left to dry by her own defense. As for the Cardinals, it's Lila Nice. Yesterday it was Chloe Bobian, so changing it up for today. Nice is here, has played in 4 appearances with 3-1-0 record by 0.967 save percentage. It'll be interesting to see if she has had very inconsistent playing time, whether she can stand up to the challenge. We know Potsdam can really get going quick, as we saw in the second period, scoring two goals and then one in the third. So as for the Cardinals, it's see if they can continue with the second period, or a similar stretch to that first period yesterday. And with this line that's currently on the ice of Drew Mead, Unsworth, and Olshansky, who produced a lot of goals throughout the game yesterday. Anthony Nicole Unsworth had a 5-point night, as that's played back to the point for Colleen. On the other side, Norton shot, save made by Zerfu. The Cardinals trying to get the tip, and that'll be dumped all the way down. Icing will be called. So 18:50 remains in the period. The 3-0 shot lead for the Cards. So three shots tallied in that first minute. This is a team that averages about 44.86 shots per game. Those faceoff will come in that far red circle. It'll be that second unit for the Cards taking it. And it was Martin on the faceoff against Drew Meade. Actually, he was able to scoop away with the puck and to get this one out into neutral ice. As Potsdam heads for a change, he'll dump it all the way down. And now here comes Killeen on those near sides. Whiffed on the dump, but managed to get it all the way down. And Potsdam will play this one deep in their own zone. Bad pass there. Norton able to intercept it and send it all the way back around. As Holmes gets that first, Card's able to steal. It's Drew Meade with it on top of the slot. Quick shot and save made by Zerflew. So the Card's tallying another shot in that last possession. Nice play by Killeen, able to keep it on the point, dump it back down. The Card was chasing after it. As Riley Calhoun will take this faceoff for the Cardinals. And Wasik controlling at the point, playing it up, down Zerflew to play off her stick. Bad pass there. Quick shot from Stumm and save made. So Lily Stumm came in quick to get the shot through. You can see a little bit of after school activities there. Is a push from Swamp on Stumm. Either way, it'll be a faceoff and no whistles blown. So his faceoff will come in the near red circle as Calhoun will take this one for the Cards. As Cleary gets to that one on the far side, she's played relentlessly as she's able to get the pass through. Merrill takes this in, trying to dance past Wasik. Will have to take a step back as her shot was blocked, and it'll be played back to the point. Quick shot there. Calhoun and Emery got a piece of that one. It's Emery who will chase after the corner. So Mac Emery, D1 transfer from Merrimack College, did not play yesterday. She's typically in that extra defender spot. So we'll see here, hopefully get some minutes tonight. She's played a limited amount this season with appearing in six games, but has played very incredibly. She's a junior from Pennsylvania as McArdle takes this one over the line, going the other side for Cheney. Quick shot and glove stop by Zerflew. So a good opportunity there from McArdle getting the pass over to Cheney. Had a nice wrist there, but glove down by Zerflew. So Potsdam keeping the Cards off the boards. A little under 3 minutes into this one. As that faceoff from Whitney will be played on those far boards. As Benjamin controlling at the point. You can see puck was pushed through and now an opportunity for Potsdam. McArdle prevents that one. As Barrett came on with speed trying to secure the 2-on-1. McArdle got her stick on it first. And now here come the Cards as Whitney takes this one up the near side. Puts a quick shot on net. Save made by Zerflew. Potsdam trying to get something going here. As that play, that puck will be dumped all the way down. An icing call. So this is for Potsdam, sometimes the clear and the icing call is better than allowing the Cards to gain possession again. That's what they went for there. Just instead of trying to enter and neutralize and give the Cards another opportunity, they just played the puck all the way down and got the whistle. So this faceoff from the near red circle. It'll be Captain Andy Katanka scored two power play goals yesterday. McArdle back on the point. Quick shot was tipped down by Katanka and finds the back of the net for the goal. So a tip in front from Andy Katanka allowed the Cards to strike early. Just over 3 minutes into this one, and the Cards leading 1-0. So McArdle kind of took a little bit of a shot with a lot of spin on it. Katanka tipped it down with her stick for her 22nd of the year. She's over goal per with her 19th appearance at 22 goals. So another big start. Check that. Ivy Borg is credited with the tip on that one. So that'll be her 12th. The game is Crosset coming on with speed, save made by Zerflew. So it's actually Borg who will get credited with that goal on the tip play. It'll be her 12th of the season. As the play is played down in that near corner, 16-13 remains. Card leading 1-0 on an Ivy Borg redirection. Card's unable to get a stick on that one, so it'll be played back to the point for Killeen. Killeen dumps down for Katanka, goes over to Killeen in transition. Quick shot, save made, rebound loose in front. Potsdam able to get a stick on that one. As they'll take this one up ice, it'll be Clark puts a shot on, save made by Nice, and Borg gets to it first. So the Cards trying to skate this one through neutral ice. It's Bork who has scored today on that far side. He'll play this one, trying to get back to the point for Dampier. And couldn't get a stick on that one. Puck was played all the way down. Burke got away with it. And just could not get a shot through. Cards defense did a good job getting back. So it'll be Dampier with it again. And the team, both teams battle for it in that near corner. And now here comes Drew Mead through her own zone. Like I said, it's a line to watch out for as they produce goals quick as Drew Mead trying to dance to the defense. Quick shot and scored! Puck was tipped back to May Olshans, who ripped the wrister through top shelf. And just like that, the Cards up 2-0. That's Olshansky's third goal in 2 days. And her 12th of the season for the sophomore. What a year she is putting together, but an absolute wicked wrister from the slot. And now Olshansky, who scored the fourth most goals, tied for fourth most of the goals on the Cardinals team. Man, what a wicked shot from the sophomore. And now the Cards, something we saw yesterday after scoring, just keeps the offensive pressure on. So, Benjamin takes this one up the near side. And dumps it all the way down. And both teams will play this one on that far corner. They'll battle for it on the near side. Potsdam able to break through with the puck as Merrill will take this up the ice on that far side. Guarded by Benjamin, trying to get across the boards. Cannot make the pass through. Shot was blocked in front. Looks like a Bear blocked the attempted shot. McArdle got to it. So it's only one shot so far from the Bears as Unsworth gets this. Takes one all the way to that shot and save made. So 2-0 lead for the Cardinals with 14:07 remaining in the first. Faceoff from the far red circle. A big opportunity there for the Cards. Like we said, the Bears only counting one shot so far. Cards with 11 as their third unit out. Played back to the point for Killeen. Killeen going down low for Martin. Back over to Killeen at the top of the point. Long shot and save made. Potsdam will get up with this one. Got past Norton. An opportunity there. Shot and save made. It was Clark who registered that one. Nice save by Nice. This one will go off the glass. Killeen gets to this one on the near side. And now Martin up to Stum, trying to dance through with it and is prevented. But Calhoun will come in for support and take it in herself, trying to make a nice through the legs move. Past Teachout, who got her stick on the puck. And now Potsdam escapes with it. Quick pass there is broken up as Killeen gets it up for Chaney. Chaney dancing around with it. It'll go back to the point for Whitney. Whitney on the other side. Play went wide as Chaney gets to it first in the corner. As that'll go back out into neutral ice. That's Emery playing this one all the way down. Both teams will get to this one on the far side. And the puck will be played out into that far corner. With 12:44 remaining, Cards still leading 2-0. Attempted pass there was blocked by Hurd. Hurd on the other side for Katanka. Trying to dance through with speed and cannot. Shake this one all the way behind the net. Katanka turns the other way and sends it out to Boric. Boric will take this one on the other side. Potsdam battles for it. Boric cannot get through with it. Puck will be played off the boards. Nice play from Emery, who dumps it all the way down. And they'll send this one off the far boards. As Holmes sent this one out into neutral ice. I'm sorry, Dunlap sent it out into neutral ice. That puck went off cross and out near the red circle. Borg gets to it first, trying to dance to the defense. Gets it over to Katanka. Shot put on net and save made by Zerflew. So Cards still leading 2-0. with 11:52 remaining, and they've really turned it up in this last couple sessions, getting a couple good opportunities. This faceoff will come on the far side, and it'll be Katanka taking it versus Delaneve. He played back the point. Now Benjamin with it. Benjamin long shot went wide. And Potsdam trying to send out neutralize. Said Potsdam only tallied one shot so far today as Bork plays this one off the boards. Katanka rushes down to it. Pass sent to the other side. Crosscheck with the interception. And it'll go back to the point for McArdle. McArdle over to Benjamin on the other side. Back to McArdle. Long shot save made. Rebound in front. Nobody's home. Bork gets to that one. And a nice block there from Sheehan, who looked like she was down on one knee, able to get in the way of Bork's shot. Now this puck will be played in that far corner. Attempted centering pass is blocked as puck was intercepted and sent off those far boards. McArdle getting to it first as she'll send it out for the captain, Katanka. Coming on with speed, trying to get the pass across. It cannot. Nice defensive play from Delaneve getting in the way of Katanka. The other captain, McArdle, gets to this one first. Both teams battling for it. As Potsdam able to weigh away with it, as Merrill will take this pass Bork and try and get into her own zone. Benjamin playing physical. As Unsworth was physically challenged, just made the safe play and dumped it back down to Potsdam's zone. Whiff there from the Bears. As Olshansky got her stick on it first, and now here comes Potsdam as Green trying to take this one through neutral ice. And offsides will be called. So 10:23 remains in the first. Cards up 14-1 in shots. This faceoff will come in the near red circle. It'll be Drew Mead taking it against Teachout. Potsdam able to get away with the win as Colleen places one up and off the boards for Olshansky. Puck went off a ref and sent all the way down by the Bears. Colleen will touch it first. Play this one off the glass for Unsworth. Long pass there, hit Olshansky in stride. She gets it over to Drew Mead. Drew Mead long shot, glove down by Zerflu. So Zerflu has already made 13 saves through just 10 minutes of the game. Is being tested early on. Already has allowed two. This faceoff will come in the far red circle. It'll be Calhoun taking it versus Dunlap. A stump coming in for support, trying to jump this one off the glass. Interesting strategy from the freshman. Either way, Potsdam able to get their stick on the puck as Banez sent it out into neutral ice. Nice play there from Colleen to get it away from Barrett. Now Calhoun battles for it on the other side. Martin will pick this one up, skating through the offensive zone, trying to send to the other side. Nobody was home, and now Potsdam will play it off the boards. Norrin with on the play there is a penalty. Was it like a, sorry, no penalty was called there. Colleen gets to it first. She'll play it off the glass for Martin. She'll send it to the other side for Norrin. So trying to dump this one down. Potsdam gets to it first as Holmes trying to take this up the ice. Dampier got in the way. And now Delaneve plays this one to the other side for Potsdam. Tried to get Nifty off the boards there. Card said no, and now they'll try again as Cheney going up for Whitney. Whitney trying to evade the defense, able to get past her man. Get it over to Hurd, quick shot. A little bit of a one-timer from Tess Hurd. Not able to get it home as Dampier playing it other side for Wasik. Long shot, save made by Zerflu. So Zerflu's been excellent on those long shots. So two goals today, one came off a misdirection and the other came off a quick shot in the slot. But either way, it's a 2-0 lead. It's 8:28 remaining. Cheney trying to get this one back to the point. Play is broken up, and now here comes the Bears as Green over. Quick shot, save made. So a big test there for the Cards as Green went over to Clark on the 2-on-1, and Nice came across and made the save. So her biggest stop so far, only has tallied two today. Plattsburgh doing a good job keeping the puck away from their netminder. as quick turn and release there went wide, looked like it went off a Cardinal stick as the attempted pass off the boards was intercepted. It's a quick shot there, save made. Teach out, tried to take the ripper underneath, play went wide, and now Wasik will control behind the net. This is played up for Cheney and trying to dump it back down into the Potsdam zone. As here comes Swamp, Shades came across and save made by Nice. So 2-0 Cardinal lead with 7:31 remaining. Cardinals now up to 16 shots. Really have laid the pressure on Zerflu. He's made a lot of very nice stops today. So Cards able to win defensive zone faceoff. Benjamin sending it across. I'm sorry, McArdle sending it across for Benjamin. Heschel dump it all the way up. Katanka getting to this one with space, trying to make the pass through. A great diving play there from Quinn to keep the captain away from the net. So now Benjamin send the pass back. McArdle coming in for support. That's Katanka back up to Benjamin. Long shot. Big block in front by Barrick. They'll feel that one tomorrow as Sarah Barrick got in the way of the big slap shot. It's Katanka going back to the point. Another block with McArdle again. Down low for Katanka. Couldn't get her stick on that one. And now both teams will pin this one up in that near side corner. Nice play from Bork. Keep it in the zone. And both teams still battling on that near side. This one will be played out. Now here comes Potsdam as Merrill trying to get past McArdle and does. So Merrill, she tried to dance five full on Benjamin who said no. The Cardinals couldn't get the clear there. Potsdam sent it back down into their own, or into Plattsburgh zone. It's a good interception there. Quick shot, save made, play tipped down in front, rebound loose. And that one will find the back of the net. So a broken play there is an intercepted pass. Got the shot on net. People digging at the rebound, and it found the goal. So with 6 minutes remaining, the Potsdam able to strike and cut the lead in half. It'll be interesting to see who ends up getting credited for this one. But either way, Potsdam only down one with 6 minutes remaining in the first. Now the faceoff will come at center ice. It's definitely one not only Nice probably wants back, but the Cardinals defense allowing the puck get his way to the net, and then that rebound to be dug in. So Dellen Nice getting credited with the goal. As that shot gets all the way to the net, rebound went loose. Delaneve gets her fourth goal of the season. His quick shot there was blocked by Colleen. Nice play from Teachout coming on with speed as she controls again. Her backhand was blocked, and now Drew Mead will take this one through neutral ice. So the grad student puts the puck all the way on net. Zerfu played it out. Big hit there on Drew Mead. As the long shot there was blocked, his play will be whistled down as Drew Mead struggling to get up. Olshansky over there to help her as trainer heads on the ice. So yesterday the Cards had trouble with Bridget Orr who went down, and then that one was a scary hit. On the far side, Drew Mead able to get up and skate off the ice. So we'll see what they end up doing with her, someone to keep an eye on. She's been a big contributor for the Cards, the grad student with 10 goals, 7 assists, and 17 points. So it looks like she's just going to take a second on the bench as the refs discuss what happened. So 2-1 Cardinal lead with 5:15 left. Plattsburgh leading 18-3 in shots as Calhoun will take this faceoff against Martin. Calhoun able to bat that one through as she was tripped up on her own skates. And now here comes Potsdam playing the other side. Quick shot was... stick was on that one as Wasik gets to it first. He's trying to battle it through, and it'll be sent back down for Wasik again. So over on the other side, long pass up to Calhoun, who puts on the brakes. She sends this one to the other side. Martin gets to it first to play it back to the point for Wasik. On the other side for Emery. Emery long shot save was made. Zerblu with a scoop that one up to break up play with 4:38 remaining. So Katanka will take this faceoff against Delany on that far red circle. Katanka with room. Quick shot scored! Annie Katanka takes this one off the faceoff and into the back of the net. And the Cards go up 3-1 with 4:33 left. So a big goal from the captain, her 22nd of the season. And man, what a play. Just took it off the faceoff. Able to take a quick shot and get it past Zerflu. Now the Cards leading 3-1 with 4:33 left. So this first line for the Cards has been unbelievably potent. They strike again. Now on the other side, pass sent to the other side. McArdle will chase after it first. Start battling with Clark there. Goal called unassisted, just an incredible play from Katanka, winning the faceoff and takes it through the red circle and into the back of the net. As Krosnek coming up to the near side, shots went off the side of the net. Katanka trying to play this one back to Krosnek, couldn't get her stick on it as they send it around. That's Katanka and Green chase after Green was able to chase this one out of the zone. And she'll send it all the way back down. Knees. Place one behind the net is play will be whistled down. Faceoff will come in center ice. For the Cards, it'll be Whitney taking this one. For the Cards, it's Potsdam in the midst of a change, trying to figure out what's going on here. So they get fresh players on the ice. As Martin takes his face up against Whitney. So Colleen dumping this one all the way off. Chaney coming on with speed. Now Chaney going back to the point, sent this one deep off the glass as Whitney gets to it first in that far corner. Whitney trying to get on the other side to Colleen and gets past her and off the boards, dumped all the way back down into the Cardinal zone. So Whitney, back over to Norton, shot and save made. As Hurd trying to play it back for Colleen. It'll be her again. Shot was blocked there by Barrett. Colleen picking up the loose rebound. Potsdam will get a stick on her attempted shot. So Chaney picking up the rebound, sends it across for Hurd. Hurd trying to evade the defense, it cannot. So now here comes the Bears as Banez up this all the way back down. Nice able to get her stick on it. And now Norton putting on the brakes as she tries to skate this one up the ice. It's Norton through neutral ice. Takes a quick shot and save made. So Unsworth play it back for Dampier. Both teams will battle for it and send it back out to neutralize. Drew Mead gets to it first, back on the ice after that. She was slow to get up just a few moments ago. Puck will be played around. Dampier gets to it first. She tries to send it back in. She's met by Merrill. As play will be played deep down in the Cardinal zone. Wasik all the way across for Olshansky. Olshansky, that one, her attempted pass went off of Merrill. And now the Cards will have to regroup in their own zone. Wasik, long pass to Olshansky, got past her stick. As Cleary whiffed on the pass. And Potsdam will be able to come in for support. A quick shot there, blocker stop. Teach out with a nice play there. As Nice able to get her pad on it. Now Unsworth. As Drew Mead trying to evade the defense there and cannot. It'll be played back down to the corner with 1:13 remaining in the period. Cards leading 24-6 in shots with a 3-1 lead as Olshansky plays this one all the way back down. As Mark gets to it first at the 1 minute mark as Cleary trying to send it up. And Potsdam will play this one off the, try to play it off the bench. So now Martin coming in again. Over to Calhoun. Calhoun, quick shot save made by Zerflus. Spinning pucks behind the net as Stum. Trying to go on the other side for Calhoun and cannot. And now here comes Potsdam. Play was intercepted there as Martin going over for Stum. Stum, quick shot, went wide. She picked up her own rebound. Ripped it to the other side as McArdle will get to it first. McArdle trying to get nifty there, faked the pass and sent it through the slot, blocked by Potsdam. The Bears trying to get the clear here with only 8 seconds remaining in the period. It's Benjamin over to Stum. This play was played off of Benjamin. McArdle gets to it first as time expires. So through one, the Cards leading 3-1 and tallying 25-6 in shots. It's a very strange period for the Cardinals, who while tallying three had a lot of issues with puck possession, just could not control as well and dominantly as they had yesterday. However, were able to keep the puck away from their goaltender, Nice only having to make 6 stops in that period and really played well. So, like I said, had only her 5th appearance of the season and was all over the puck. So a solid period from them. As for Potsdam's goaltending, Ellie Zerflew again. Defense kind of left her to dry in a lot of these possessions. All three of those goals were situations where it was hard for her to make the stop and wasn't able to on those. But on the remaining shots, she just came up big, especially preventing the tips and the long plays from the point. But either way, the Cardinals are going to have to work on the puck possession going into this period, trying to control and be a little better with the forecheck as play just looked a lot more broken up and not as smooth as it was yesterday. We saw yesterday in the first period and really throughout all periods, the Cardinals moved extremely effortlessly through the offensive zone. Today, Potsdam able to improve that aspect of game as being a little bit better when the Cardinals are asked to cross the blue line. So going to the second, Cards try to work on that. As for Potsdam, it's just capitalizing your opportunities, try to make more creative shots and not a lot. We saw many Cardinal shots, Bear shots get blocked on possessions. So that'll be something the Cards need to work on going into this one. The Cards will be need to work on just staying in front of the shots like they did in that last period. And keep doing that. As for Potsdam, try to clear the defense, but it'll be interesting to see what both teams do. The Cards trying to maintain their lead going into the second one. We saw yesterday in the second struggled immensely, allowing two, hopefully not for the same fate today. So from Ronald B. Saturday's Arena, we will see you in the second period of action. Thank you.
All right, an exhilarating first period from the Stafford Ice Arena as the Cardinals are up 3-1 against the Potsdam Bears. Let's take you through that period again, starting off with the first goal of the game. Came early on, just a little over 3 minutes in, as Annie Katanka, who ended up getting credited for that goal, unassisted, was able to put it into the back of the net for the Cardinals' first score, and they kept going from there. May Olshansky decided to tack on another goal a little less than a minute and a half later, and we'd go on through most of the remainder of the period without seeing any scoring. But after a Potsdam goal, Plattsburgh came right back, and who else but Annie Katanka to score it again. We've seen the Cardinals play some incredible offense this game too, continuing to take rebound after rebound to keep the puck in their offensive zone against Potsdam, not giving them much time to breathe. Although when they did get a chance to breathe, they let one into the goal. Although we've seen a great performance by Plattsburgh's defense as well, able to keep Potsdam with only one goal on the board. So moving forward for Plattsburgh, we'll look to see some more of that offense and just keeping their foot on the gas. They've done an absolutely incredible job doing it throughout this game and throughout the season. So we'll see if Potsdam can try and fight back. We saw them put up two goals last night in the second period. So we'll see if they can do it again. Although look out for Plattsburgh, as the second period this season has been their best so far. Although we've seen some great first period and third period play the last two nights, we'll look to see if they can capitalize in the second period and put this game away early. That's all we've got so far. We'll come back to you at the beginning of the second period. Stay tuned.
TG in one word to me means integrity.
It's responsibility.
It's trust.
Solidarity.
Synergy.
Home. These guys are my home.
Theta Gamma is welcoming.
In one word, TG means to me family.
I'm Vincent Perno, president of Theta Gamma. Here at Theta Gamma, we emphasize the importance of scholarship, leadership, and service. We strive to make ourselves better people as well as our community a better place.
My name is John Lynch. I'm the president of the school's animation club. While other colleges' animation clubs strive to only show just straight anime, our club tries to be something different, as we show a variety of things such as Western animation, Eastern animation, internet animation, films, and so much more. If you want to meet people who have some like-minded taste in animation, then feel free to come on down to our club.
Botany Club is a group of students who enjoy learning about and experiencing the natural world, especially plants, through various activities, trips, and service projects.
If you're interested in joining Botany Club, please join us at Hudson Hall on Tuesdays at 6 p.m. And for more information, reach out to us on Instagram at Botanical Society SUNY Plats. Hope to see you there.
So people should join Quake because it is the only radio station here on campus where you get to control everything. You get to have your own music. You can talk about whatever you want. I mean, this semester alone, they want to do a lot of sports shows. I also have somebody who wants to talk about true crime. Me personally, I'm big into music. Quake is one of those groups where we want diversity and we want to just have a good time.
Hi, I'm Nick Putney. I am the president of eSports. We have 11 different teams. We compete against schools nationwide. We also just have various kind of more casual games. We have people playing Minecraft. We have a kind of group chat of sorts where we have people just hang out and talk about games. More than anything, a community of people who kind of share similar interests.
The sword of jiu-jitsu is mainly for, you can use it for self-defense. That's the number one reason it appeals to people. There's other people who come to this club for the competition aspect, and also a lot of others who do it for the workout aspect. It has multiple ways of appealing to different audiences, and you should come give it a try. You might like it.
Dance Corps makes me feel confident.
Dance Corps means to me family.
Dance Corps is motivating.
Dance Corps means new friends.
Dance Corps means old friends.
Dance Corps means unity.
Dance Corps means creativity.
Dance Corps means love.
Dance Corps is fun.
Dance Corps means friendship.
Dance Corps is exciting.
Dance Corps is my support system.
Dance Corps is my favorite thing.
PS News is a live show put together by just a bunch of college students. And we put it out to the public for everybody to see. Different segments that we have with PS News. We have national news, we have world news, and we cover sports and pop culture news as well.
It's been a lot of fun, especially this semester. We have a great crew and talent that make it amazing.
We go live Monday through Thursday from 7 and 7:30.
Welcome to PS News.
So TEK is Tau Kappa Epsilon. It's a national fraternity. It's one of the biggest in the nation right now. We're about 37 guys. We do our best to serve the community that we are a part of, and we really like to give back. In my opinion, what makes TEK stand out is just the amount of leadership skills that you will develop as a TEK. As time progresses, as you go through the rush process, you realize just like how genuine the people are in this organization.
Better men for a better world. Rush TEK.
Jump on in and fly high with the Cardinals only at Memorial Hall.
Integrity.
It's responsibility.
It's trust.
Solidarity.
Synergy.
Home. These guys are my home.
Theta Gamma is welcoming.
In one word, TG means to me family.
I'm Vincent Perno, president of Theta Gamma. Here at Theta Gamma, we emphasize the importance of scholarship, leadership, and service. We strive to make ourselves better people as well as our community a better place.
Hello, my name is John Lynch. I'm the president of the school's animation club. While other colleges' animation clubs strive to only show just straight anime, our club tries to be something different, as we show a variety of things such as Western animation, Eastern animation, internet animation, films, and so much more. If you want to meet people who have like-minded taste in animation, then feel free to come on down to our club.
Botany Club is a group of students who enjoy learning about and experiencing the natural world, especially plants, through various activities, trips, and service projects.
If you're interested in joining Botany Club, please join us at Hudson Hall on Tuesdays at 6 p.m.
And for more information, reach out to us on Instagram at Botanical Society Suny Plats. Hope to see you there.
So people should join Quake because it is the only radio station here on campus where you get to control everything. You get to have your own music. You can talk about whatever you want. I mean, this semester alone, they want to do a lot of sports shows. They also have somebody who wants to talk about true crime. Me personally, I'm big into music. Quake is one of those groups where we want diversity and we want to just have a good time.
Welcome back to Ronald D. Staff Rice Arena for another period of Cardinal hockey. After one, Plattsburgh leading 3-1, it was a two-goal period from captain Andy Katanka, tallying her 22nd and 23rd goal for an easily team lead. Keep in mind, she only played in 19 games. That puts her over goal per, so adding to an incredible season, including an unassisted one at the end of the period. The other goal for the Cards came from the sophomore, May Olshanty, who took a big wrist shot from the slot, able to get it past Ellie Zerflew. And then one goal for the Bears, it was Emily Delaney, fifth of the season. As for the Potsdam goaltending, Ellie Zerflew, someone we talked about quite a bit in that last period, making 22 stops with three goals allowed. The Cards really putting the pressure on her in that one, trying to put up a similar performance to yesterday where they had a five-goal first period. But when we talk about yesterday, we need to talk about the second period where they allowed two and allowed the Bears to get momentum and get back into the game. When I spoke with multiple players on the Cardinals, it was all a similar statement of how that second period was rough and need to play a more consistent kind of game. Hoping to see that in this one for the Cards. As for Potsdam, like I mentioned at the end of the last one, is taking advantage of the opportunities you get. You don't see a lot of shots, only Nice only having to make five saves. You don't see a lot of opportunities through this relentless Cardinals play. And you have to take advantage of the ones you can get. You saw a lot of blocks in that last period. So as we gear up for our second period of play, we'll see if the Cards can maintain the pressure they've put on in the first period, or if Potsdam will try to get back in this one. As we mentioned, Potsdam playing extreme desperation hockey as they attempt to secure that last playoff spot, currently sitting in fourth place overall in the Newell, only 2 points ahead of SUNY Cannes. SUNY Cannes actually plays the Cardinals this week. As we gear up for the second period of action here, like we said, 3-1 lead for the Plattsburgh Cardinals. It'll be the Cardinals' first line on the ice of Annie Katanka, Sarah Crossing, and Ivy Bora. Katanka credited with two goals in that last period, so an incredible performance for the captain, who had her second game straight with two goals. Correction, her third game straight, actually, with two goals. So 6 goals in the last 3 games is whiff shot there from Carly Green. As the Cards try to battle this one on the near side. Long shot there, save made by Nice. So Teachout picked up that loose puck and took the very long shot. Nice all over that, making her sixth stop of the contest. So 19:45 remains. This faceoff will come in the near red circle. Katanka able to get the win back over to Benjamin. And Potsdam with a turn and shoot has a big hit in the crease. So we saw Teachout again just spin around with the puck and rip the shot through. As a big save was made, and icing will be called. Faceoff will come in the Cardinals zone. So first 30 seconds, Potsdam doing a good job keeping it in the offensive zone as they try to strike again and minimize the lead. So we'll see what the Cards first unit can do on this one. Not able to win the faceoff. McArdle made a diving pass across the boards as it'll be sent out into Potsdam zone and icing will be called again. So two back-to-back icing. But as this faceoff will come in the Cardinal zone. Talk able to get another win there as Benjamin plays this one on the other side for McArdle. So McArdle dump this all the way down as icing will be called again. So three straight icings. This faceoff will come in the near red circle up the Cardinal zone. So that he's had three straight icings on three straight possessions. The Cardinals are not able to get a stick on the puck. see if they can get the clear they desperately need so far, as that'll be sent all the way across. Shot went wide, and McArdle gets to it first, so a nice shot from Sheehan. Unfortunately, just missed the goal as McArdle brings this one through neutral ice. Now offsides will be called, so very ugly play so far for the Cards, so they can finally get fresh players on after the icing situation. This faceoff will come in the going into Potsdam zone. It'll be Drew Mead taking it versus Martin. Now Colleen. Play this one, send it all the way down as they battle for it. Swamp and Drew Mead. Olshansky coming in for support with 18:40 left, and they'll be sent back to the point. Cards not able to get possession of it, and Potsdam will get the clear as Colleen dumping this one all the way down. Olshansky and Swamp chase after it. Cards able to pick up the loose rebound as Unsworth takes this one from behind the net. She eyes her options. Unsworth trying to get it across, knocked the stick out of the hand, knocked another stick out of the hand. So Unsworth being an equipment monster. But Potsdam able to wait away with the puck as Cleary sent this one behind the net. Colleen picks it up, skates it around to the other side. She'll send the pass over to Olshansky, over to Unsworth in transition on the other side for Drew Mead. Drew Mead's shot. They got a stick on that one as Bannis got in the way. But either way, the Cardinals trying to maintain control behind the net cannot. As attempted pass by Potsdam was missed, and the Cards will let this trickle down for icing as 17:41 remains in the second period. No goals yet, as Cards leading 3-1. Faceoff will come in the far red circle. As Stump trying to use the body to get control of it and cannot. And now Potsdam able to control their own end. Quick turn and shoot and save made by Nies. As Emery, a player went down there, was able to wait away with the puck. And now here comes the Cards as Martin takes this one up the far sides. Martin the first here, trying to go back to the point. As they, both teams still going back and forth in the corner. And Potsdam able to escape with the puck as Calhoun taken down in transition there, and play is whistled down. So 16:54 there, and a really say broken kind of hockey where both teams just kind of going back and forth. No really solid opportunities quite yet through just over 3 minutes of play, as Whitney will take this face off against Delaneve. To McArdle, over to Benjamin. As she tries to get up for Chaney, and now they'll battle for it on the line. Pass went out. It Heard with the making able to make the interception. And that'll be swished into the Cardinal bench. Now faceoff will come in the Cardinal zone. As Whitney will take his face off against Delaneve, Card's fourth line out there. It's McArdle dumping this one all the way down as Hurd chasing after it. Now it'll be played in the corner. Whitney able to evade with it. She'll go back to the point for Benjamin. On the other side for McArdle. McArdle is trying to get it over to Chaney, who is tied up. Pass there from Potsdam, picked up by Hurd. Now McArdle long shot, that one went wide. Benjamin picking up the rebound, goes back down low for Whitney. It'll be over to Benjamin. Benjamin's shot. Cards couldn't gain possession of it. It's now Chaney trying to get over Hurd, who's on the ground. And Potsdam able to take advantage as they try to skate it through neutral ice and send it down into the Cardinal zone. As Chambers battles with Benjamin. Chambers tried to make a centering pass. Benjamin able to get her stick on it. Now she'll dump it all the way down. Nice interception there. That's Krosnick goes to the other side for Boric, who tries to poke it through. And this puck will be sent all the way back down to the Cardinal zone as icing will be called. So 15:20 remaining in the second period. Cards still leading 3-1. A very back and forth type period here. This faceoff will come in the far red circle. Tatanka taking the faceoff against. Against Delaneve, I believe, is Colleen. Going the other side for Krosnick. Back over to Tatanka. And now Borg shot. Whiffed on that one. Went over the glass, or into the glass, as Krosnick missed her pass to Tatanka. And now the attempted clear from Potsdam's block, and the Cards will be down low with it as Tatanka fell going backwards. Now Krosnick sending it back to her captain. Puts it back to the point. As Colleen tried to send a nice pass over there, Bork just couldn't get a hold of the shot. So great pass from Emma Colleen. And now Tatanka to get away with it. Her puck went off the glass. Bork missed it, and Crossing came in for support. He'll send it back to the point for Norton. Norton, who skates with it. Her shot is blocked by Merrill. Or check that, block by Holmes. And now Cardinals try again, 2-on-1 here is Tatanka over to Krosnick, who could not keep it on her stick. So big opportunity there. So last Krosnick just couldn't come up with control of the puck. And this will be played high off the glass by the Bears. As Holmes trying to get over to the other side. Drew Mead took a quick shot. They have fun back to the net. Now here come the Bears. That one will be sent all the way down. Colleen chases after it with Teach Out. As Teach Out picks this one up again, coming in on Colleen. Her shot save made by Knees with 13:40 left. So Lila Knees up to 8 saves on the game. As Bo Bien was played yesterday, played an excellent game tonight. Knees is in. The junior from California has this play. She may get tested again here as Potsdam sent that shot wide. Dampier pushes it across for Olshansky, who pushes it back into Potsdam's zone. A teach out, trying to send it to the other side. It trickles all the way down to the goal as Nice hangs on to that one with 13:18 left. So no is really significant opportunities aside from that 2-on-1 just a moment ago. For either team, there's a lot of just very back and forth hockey. Looks like the Cards just trying to run the clock a little bit. See if they can get going on this one from their own zone. As Drew Mead will take this faceoff against Merrill. Puck will be played deeper into that Card zone as Wasik gets to it first. Back over to Unsworth. It'll be Wasik again trying to go across for Dampier. The Olshansky back low. And now Olshansky over to Drew Mead. Comes into the far side. Quick shot, save made by Zerflew, who dives on the rebound and holds on to play. Cards up to 27 shots today. So the offense still ringing here. As Calhoun will take this faceoff for the Cards, as Potsdam had an extra player on the ice. As Cleary heads for the bench. And I'll go back to point. McArdle's shot. Rebound loose in front. Calhoun tried to get to it and couldn't get control. Potsdam jumped on the opportunity there. As Martin fell over in transition. So Stumm will play this one back. On the other side for McArdle. Trying to play this one off the boards for Martin. Nice interception there from the Bears. Cards able to regain control and push out to neutral ice. That pass went off of Stumm and dumped all the way down. Stumm trying to go to Calhoun down low. Play was intercepted by Delaneve. Push out to neutral ice. Cards getting in the way of that one and dumping it back down to the Potsdam zone. So really just back and forth here so far. No team getting any significant amount of puck possession or time as Benjamin's pass missed Calhoun and be dumped all the way down as icing will be called. It's another example of that. So the faceoff will come in the card zone. Knees up to 9 stops. Surflu up to 24. So another incredible showing from the sophomore. As that shot gets in front of the net, rebound loose, and play will be whistled down. The Potsdam bench did not like that. So this faceoff will come in the near red circle. Hart still leading 3-1 with 11:49 remaining in the period. And a lot of stoppages, just like I said earlier, no team really able to get anything going in through this frame. The pass went off of Cardinal, and Bork able to pick it up, sends it all the way across for Krosnack. So Krosnack coming on with speed, quick shot, save made by Zerflu. Cards jump on the rebound as Katanka trying to send it back to the point, and Potsdam to get away with it. Potsdam doing a better job picking up opportunities as looks like we're getting our first penalty of the game. As Sarah Barrett heads to the box, so the Cards, who really are having trouble getting any momentum, a very stagnant period of hockey, will be able to go to the power play here. So the Cards' first unit on the ice. Space off here, won by the Cards, is Krosnack. Nice little play there to get away from the body. Now both teams battle for it on that near corner. Both teams taking out an effective play from Potsdam, trying to run the clock. By the way, Krosnack coming out with it, going back to the point for McArdle. Goes to the top for Boric. Now over to McArdle. McArdle down low for Benjamin. Benjamin back to the point, coming out, quick shot. Pad stop from Zerflu, and now Boric. Back over to McArdle again. Now top over to Boric. 1:23 remaining in the penalty. It's Benjamin in front of Katanka's shot and save made. So 1:16 remaining on the power play for the Cards, as it'll be McArdle with it again. Over to the other side for Benjamin. Benjamin will go over to Krosnack in transition. So now McArdle over to Boric. Boric shot save made. The empty clear was blocked, and then Potsdam able to get the clear. So Plattsburgh yesterday went got two separate power play goals. Both came from Annie Katanka. This season, the power play is 27-82 with a 32.9%. This puck will be dumped all the way down again. Nice gets to do it. That's 45 seconds remaining on the power play for the Cards. So Benjamin on the other side for Drew Mead. And he kills 70% for Potsdam. Allowed 22 goals in 71 attempts. So it'll be over to Benjamin. Her attempted pass, Olshansky just couldn't get her stick on it with 26 left. So Benjamin, don't miss all the way down. So it'll be Olshansky over to Unsworth. Now back to the top for Drew Mead, who goes over to Unsworth again. And Olshansky in front, just backhanded and lifted over the net with 10 seconds left. Wasik takes a shot, tipped in front by Olshansky, rebound loose. Unsworth couldn't get her stick on that one. As now Drew Mead again with the penalty expiring. Centering pass is tipped. And now Potsdam just trying to get the pass through and cannot. So Platt's 0-for-1 on the power play so far. So the first sequence of this period is a long shot there. First sequence of this period where they've able to gain solid zone time is Wasik. Over to Norton. Now back to Drew Mead. Drew Mead's shot and save made by Zerflu. Now Potsdam escapes with the puck. Now they just attempt to get the clear. Norton making the interception. Now she'll send this one all the way around. No team battle for it behind the net. No team really able to get a solid possession there. Cards able to send it back to the point as Colleen's attempted pass was picked up by Hurd, dumped down low is Cheney. Trying to get it over to Hurd. The puck was loose in front. And now here comes Potsdam as Green. Long shot there, that one went wide. And now Whitney. Over to Colleen on the far side. Colleen tried to dump this one down. And now defenders will go back and forth to Swamp. Sends this one way down in the Cardinal zone as Colleen gets to it first and dumps it around the other side of the boards. As a long pass attempted, an icing will be called. So Norton tried to go from essentially end to end, trying to center one out. But Card's not able to intercept the pass and clear possession. So 3-1 Cardinal lead here. No goals yet with 7:46 remaining. As Whitney will take this face off. As Cheney tried to get on it and cannot. As there's a shot save made. So Merrill tried to do a little bit of a turn and shoot. As Colleen looks like fell on the puck. Now Potsdam out to the top of the point. Shot was tipped in front. Cardinals able to scoop up the rebound. Whitney sending this one all the way up for Cheney as Cards head for a change. Cheney skates it around herself. She's looking the centering pass for Drew Mead as she heads for the bench. Drew Mead had to pick this one up on the near boards. Play was blocked there. Cards picking this one up to keep it onside. As Drew Mead tried to get through and could not. Now here comes Potsdam as Chambers. Long shot there and save made by Neese. We'll play it down for McArdle. Nice little possession play from the goalie. Unsworth coming on with speed here. Dance around one defender. Quick shot. Save made. Rebound loose in front. Cards trying to jump on this one. Olshansky plays it back for Unsworth, so the big opportunity from Unsworth, who made a nice move around the defender, couldn't get the goal through, similar to something yesterday, but this time couldn't find the back of the net. As McArdle's pass is blocked, gets by her, and now Potsdam will send this one to neutralize, so a huge opportunity for the Plattsburgh second unit. As this one will be sent around with 6:17 left. As it'll be Holmes. She went off of Drew Mead's skate. Now Boric chopped it out and now maintains control. So Boric over to Katanka on the other side. Katanka in front, save made. The captain sends it back to the point for Benjamin. Over to the other captain to McArdle. This will be Benjamin again on the other side for Boric. Boric shot, nice block there from Sheehan. Now the Cards. Katanka with a big opportunity there, couldn't get it through. Zerflu is pinned up. Now Benjamin going down low for Krosnick. Back to point for McArdle. McArdle shot and save made by Zerflu. So Zerflu stands tall in a Cardinals first unit onslaught. Is now up to 30 saves through just over halfway. So 5:32 left, offensive zone faceoff for the Cards. As Potsdam coming on with speed here as Neese will play this one out wide. As Whitney over to the other side for Wasik as Whitney again. Whitney able to win the offensive zone faceoff as Wasik sends it across as Emery long pass there. Nice little play as her just couldn't get her stick on the puck. And now Potsdam picking this one up behind the net. It'll be sent all the way across for Green as Green's play is intercepted from Swamp. So a little bit of a weird play where Potsdam's got in the way physically. And now Wasik takes this one herself. Pass over to Drew Mead as she crosses the line herself. Drew Mead trying to center in front, cannot. Nice play from Unsworth coming to intercept it as she comes on with speed. Unsworth's shot hit the pipe as Unsworth picking up her own rebound. She still skates around with it. Finally, let go. Back to the point for Emery. On the other side for Norrin. Norrin, who dances with it, trying to get the shot through, and went down into the corner as Unsworth picking up the rebound. On the other side for Norrin. Now back to Drew Mead, over to Olshansky in front. Tries to push this one through and cannot. This intercepting pass. Or was not intercepted, I'm sorry, as Olshansky will dance it through. Olshansky with Drew Mead to her right. Olshansky shot, save made, as Olshansky put her own rebound on net. Carr trying to crash the crease there, but Zerflew able to get on top of it with 3:39 left. No goals to show so far as the Cards turning up the offensive notch here in the last 10 minutes of play. As Katanka will take this faceoff for the Cards in the offensive zone. Big faceoff here as they're getting very close to finding the back of the net. We'll see what they can do here as Norrin will dump this one down. And it'll be played across. Crossneck gets to it. We'll send it back around for Boric. Crossneck coming on. Quick shot save made. Rebound loose and Zerflew scoop it up. Man, is Zerflew's rebound control absolutely sensational. He's able to jump all over it. Because like every puck that gets in front of her, this is what's really kept the score to 3 in this period. Their ability to not allow the Cardinals to regain possession. So Katanka will take this faceoff. Able to get the win there. Borg quick shot blocked in front as Norrin skating up with speed, long shot there. That one stopped. So Krosnick back down low for Katanka. Katanka in front, Borg whiffed on the shot. It'll go back to the point for Norrin. Goes on this side for Colleen. She ripped one, looked like it got stuck on Swamp. 5'7 from Akwesasne, New York. Really showing off her size in that one. As Green attempted to get by, the car is not able to. Now Boric with room, coming out of the net, goes back for Katanka. Long shot, scored! Hat trick for Annie Katanka, and the Cards go up 4-1 with 2:48 left. So what a play from this first line as Ivy Boric skated it in, went back for Katanka, who was just so patient with it, held on, took the shot, and finally broke Zerflew, who has not allowed the goal since a 15:27 mark of the second period. So got through a whole period, really slowing down the Cardinal defense, and finally Annie Katanka, who's attributed to 3 of the Cardinal goals, a hat trick for the grad student. Is she sensational? As Calhoun. Tonka's 24th of the season. Just what a year for the grad student who's really making this one a well worth farewell tour is Benjamin. Back down low for Cheney. On the other side for McArdle. McArdle, cross for Benjamin. McArdle's coming out with a lot more momentum to that huge goal from the captain. And now Whitney plays one off the boards for Benjamin. Benjamin trying to dish it across as McArdle fields it first. McArdle tend to put the shot on and went off the back of the net. And now here come the Bears as Holmes battling with Benjamin using her physicality, and now Calhoun came in for support and tried to push it down to the offensive zone. So he played back Olshansky, nice little move there as Olshansky saw a little stick handling there. Olshansky just went back and forth with her stick, went back and forth with the puck, I'm sorry, and tried to get the shot through, and just good block there from the Bears. That's nice interception by Drew Mead, who has room to the net. Drew Mead coming to the outside, pass across, and Unsworth just couldn't get her stick on it, so she did an excellent job as Olshansky shot. But Drew Mead did an excellent job drawing Zerflew out. There's another long shot there, it's blocked or saved by Zerflew, and now Unsworth back to the point. Dampier over to Wasik. Wasik's got a wicked shot, flexed it off there, tipped in front. Save made, it's under a minute left. And now Unsworth slow things down from the top of the point. It's passed over to Wasik, who couldn't keep it onside. And whistle will be blown here with 49.4 left. Cards really turning it up here, pressure-wise, in the last few minutes of play. And it paid off with a huge goal from Annie Katanka, who was able to break away with another hat trick absolutely spectacular. She's running out of adjectives to describe how good she has played. That puck gets past Wasik. As Potsdam's attempt to get through the zone does not work, as Dampier over to Boric pushes it up for Kataka. Kataka trying to center up a cross that it cannot. As Dampier is taken down on her attempted centering pass, and now here come Potsdam, a little bit of a two on two action as they're going to get the shot through. Nice will play it off her pads and into the corner. It's Wasik. Now Kataka trying to take this one over the line. It'll be Wasik with it again as time expires. So a one goal period for the Cards, leading 4-1 through two. As the Cards lead 42-15 in shots. And this is one of those periods that's the story of two halves. In that first 10 minutes, extremely stagnant is a good word to describe it. Just lots of broken plays, lots of stoppages, many icing calls, lots of offsides, just really scrappy play for both sides, not able to get anything going. And then just about past the 10-minute mark of the period, the Cards offense started to get back into it slowly but surely, making nice passes here and there, being able to control the puck better in the offensive zone. They had a big power play there where they moved the puck around extremely effectively. And then it just felt like a matter of time at about the 3-minute mark. And then it was as Ivy Boric took it over the line with a lot of space, went back to her captain and fellow line mate Annie Kataka, who ripped the shot home. Absolutely beautiful top shelf goal from the grab zone for a hat trick. So like we said, she has been playing out of her mind recently. That would be her 7th goal in 3 games. She had 2 goals against Cortland, 2 goals yesterday against Potsdam, and then 3 today already through 2. So it'll be exciting to see what she ends up finishing. Have an absolutely exceptional season and game for Kataka. Another thing we talked about is the goaltending in that game. Goaltending in that game is Nice played a lot better. She was tested a lot more from the Bears offense, able to make 14 stops total. And then as for Zerflew, it's similar dominance. She's made 38 stops, and that includes a lot of big ones towards that, like I said, that last 10-minute stretch of the period. But as for the Cardinals going into this third, it's just keep that momentum you push together in the second half of the period. And then for Potsdam, it's just a similar last period. You don't get a lot of opportunities. You've got to capitalize. And there was a couple they really should have had in the first few minutes of the period. So it'll be interesting to see what both teams do, keeping in the third period. Obviously, Potsdam extremely desperate for a win. We'll have to bridge together 3 goals. But a lot more successful second period for Potsdam, who gave up 2 yesterday. But either way, it'll be a big third period to see whether the Cards can close this one down. So from Ronald B. Stafford and Arena, that's been your second period of action. Thank you.
Another exhilarating period of Cardinal hockey is that they now have a 4-1 lead against the Potsdam Bears. We're going to go take a look through the game to see how we got here. Starting off, we'll go all the way back to the first period for that first goal by Plattsburgh. Starting at 3 minutes, it's a little more than 3 minutes into the game, it's Kataka who finds the goal after a redirect in there. That would be her first of the day. More on Kataka in a bit. As the Cardinals will take a 1-0 lead there. Moving forward now to the later in that period, just about a minute and a half later on, it would be Olshansky who would have the time to shine. Her goal would go on to be her 12th for the season, as the Cardinals would take a 2-0 lead after it was in there, as we'll see here. A great play to get it into the back of the net with her teammate falling in front of it. An incredible play to just keep the play alive, as that first attempt at the goal didn't go so well. Finally, in the first period, the Cardinals' third goal of the period, it'd be Annie Kataka again, who unassisted would be able to find the back of the net for the Cardinals to take a 3-1 lead against Potsdam, as we'll see here. A nice goal from the captain there to get it in, as Plattsburgh, after the first period, had that 3-1 lead and And with that, the Cardinals had scored 25% of all their first period goals in just the last 24 hours. Five last night, three this afternoon. But now we take it to the second period, where the real story of the game has been Annie Katanka. We'll see her once again be able to find the back of the net, this time assisted by Ivy Boric and Maddie Norton, as the pass back goes right into the back of the net. And folks, after that goal, the Cardinals captain has a hat trick here. An absolutely incredible performance so far, and we still have a period left to play. Plattsburgh up 4-1 against the Potsdam Bears, as we will see you at the beginning of the third period. Stay tuned.
One word to me means integrity.
It's responsibility.
It's trust.
Solidarity.
Synergy.
Home. These guys are my home.
Theta Gamma is welcoming.
In one word, TG means to me family.
I'm Vincent Perno, president of Theta Gamma. Here at Theta Gamma, we emphasize the importance of scholarship, leadership, and service. We strive to make ourselves better people as well as our community a better place.
My name is John Lynch. I'm the president of the school's animation club. While other colleges' animation clubs strive to only show just straight anime, our club tries to be something different, as we show a variety of things such as Western animation, Eastern animation, internet animation, films, and so much more. If you want to meet people who have some like-minded taste in animation, then feel free to come on down to our club.
Botany Club is a group of students who enjoy learning about and experiencing the natural world, especially plants, through various activities, trips, and service projects.
If you're interested in joining Botany Club, please join us at Hudson Hall on Tuesdays at 6 p.m. And for more information, reach out to us on Instagram at Botanical Society Suny Plats. Hope to see you there.
So people should join Quake because it is the only radio station here on campus where you get to control everything. You get to have your own music. You can talk about whatever you want. I mean, this semester alone, they want to do a lot of sports shows. I also have somebody who wants to talk about true crime. Me personally, I'm big into music. Quake is one of those groups where we want diversity and we want to just have a good time.
Hi, I'm Nick Putney. I am the president of eSports. We have 11 different teams. We compete against schools nationwide. We also just have various kind of more casual games. We have people playing Minecraft. We have a kind of group chat of sorts where we have people just hang out and talk about games. More than anything, a community of people who kind of share similar interests.
The sword of jiu-jitsu is mainly for, you can use it for self-defense. That's the number one reason it appeals to people. There's other people who come to this club for the competition aspect, and also a lot of others who do it for the workout aspect. It has multiple ways of appealing to different audiences, and you should come give it a try. You might like it.
Dance corps makes me feel confident.
Dance corps means to me family.
Dance corps is motivating.
Dance corps means new friends.
Dance corps means old friends.
Dance corps means unity.
Dance corps means creativity.
Dance corps means love.
Dance corps is fun.
Dance corps means friendship.
Dance corps is exciting.
Dance corps is my support system.
Dance corps is my favorite thing.
PS News is a live show put together by just a bunch of college students. And we put it out to the public for everybody to see. Different segments that we have at PS News. We have national news, we have world news, and we cover sports and pop culture news as well.
It's been a lot of fun, especially this semester. We have a great crew and talent that make it amazing.
We go live Monday through Thursday from 7 and 7:30.
Welcome to PS News.
So TEAC is Tau Kappa Epsilon. It's a national fraternity. It's one of the biggest in the nation right now. We're about 37 guys. We do our best to serve the community that we are a part of, and we really like to give back. In my opinion, what makes TEAC stand out is just the amount of leadership skills that you will develop as a TEAC. As time progresses, as you go through the rush process, you realize just like how genuine the people are in this organization.
Better men for a better world. Rush Teak.
Jump on in and fly high with the Cardinals only at Memorial Hall.
Welcome back to Ronald D. Saffrice Arena. This is Liam Sample, and in just about a little over 3 minutes, it'll be your third period of action here. So let's review what's going on so far. Plattsburgh currently leading 4-1, and a hat trick for Annie Katanka. When I started the last period, I had high praise for the captain and grad student of the Cards, and obviously the leading scorer with her 24th goal. And I mean, she's been absolutely sensational of late with two goals against Cortland, two goals last night against Potsdam, both on the power play, and then three tonight. So continuing her absolutely fantastic farewell tour here in her last season as a Cardinal. As for that period, it was definitely, like I said, a tale of two halves. First half was very, very stagnant. It was both teams had a lot of trouble moving the puck and getting out of the zone effectively. Then the last half, the Cardinals really showed and proved why they are the number two team in the country. Just played absolutely fantastic puck possession wise, able to control play a lot better, and then obviously had a goal to show for it, as Andy Katanka's only goal of the period came at the 17-12 mark. So what do we expect from this one? For the Cards, it's defense mode. Shut down the offense for Potsdam and don't even let them get any sign of life. Three goals is a huge lead, but it's the type of lead that you can watch absolutely fall apart in front of your own eyes. You just have to be careful. As for Potsdam, it's, like I've said over and over today, take advantage of the only opportunities you get. You don't get a lot against this Plattsburgh forecheck and defense. And when you can break away with the puck, try to get into the net, take quick shots, and really test Nice. Nice has only had to make 13 stops today, and only allowed one. Put her to the test. She has not had consistent playing time this year. She could be cold. Give her the opportunity. For the Cards, it's just keep laying on that offense. Obviously, Zerflu is going to keep being herself. Already made 38 stops. Made 31 yesterday while allowing 8 today. She allowed 4, and on all 4 were hard stops to make, so it's not necessarily her fault. Has just over a minute till, or a minute and a half till play here from Plattsburgh, New York. As for the Cards, they have secured the top spot in their conference and will be, that is their 4th straight season winning the conference, and they're the only team to do it since the conference was created. As for Potsdam, obviously below 500 with an overall and conference record 8-12-1 overall and 6-8-1 in conference, and is hanging on to that 4th spot, 2 points above SUNY Canton. As for Potsdam, they may luck out here because SUNY Canton's next game is against the Cards, and last time the Cards played Canton, they won 9-1. So even with a loss today, Potsdam still may hold the lead. That game is on Tuesday in the next Plattsburgh game. So is the Plattsburgh taking the ice here? Wait to see what they do in this one, if they can hold it down. Yesterday, third period against Potsdam, they scored 3 goals and really locked down after a shaky second period. Well, this second period was a lot better than yesterday. We'll see if they can continue the same kind of success and try to find the back of the net a couple more times to lock this one down. As Potsdam just going to have to play what we like to call desperation hockey. Just, you're going to have to get aggressive and start to lay on the offensive pressure. Otherwise, you will never get back into this game against such a relentless defense. So 10 seconds till we start here as Cards taking the ice. Their first unit out there of Katanka, Boric, and Krosnek. Rightfully so, as this line is produced 3 of the 4 goals, and everyone's having excellent nights. Aaron McArdle is currently 1 point away from holding the all-time point lead of any defenseman in Plattsburgh State women hockey history. So she's someone to watch out for. She had 1 point on the first goal of the game, an assist to Andy Katanka. So both teams battle behind the Potsdam net. I'll send this one out. Krosnek to make the interception at center ice as Boric plays this one up off the boards. Katanka coming to the net with a little bit of room here, trying to dance around Swamp. Wasn't able to, as she'll field it back down in the corner. Over to Boric. Boric going across for Benjamin. Benjamin's play was broken up, and now potential opportunity there for Potsdam trying to break through Benjamin. Good play with the stick, able to keep it in the line and keep it in the zone as the Cardinals will try again. As now, here come the Bears. That one, as Benjamin made the interception, now the Cardinals will try to get it out of the zone. Nice defensive play there as Chambers try to take it to the net and cannot, so Drew Mead going up to Unsworth on the near boards. Play went off her stick. And she'll dump it back down for Drew Mead. So Plattsburgh's next game will be against Canton on the 15th. Is a shot there and save made by North. Plattsburgh's next game will be at Canton on the 15th. That is Tuesday. And then their final 2 games of the season will be this weekend against Buffalo State. Last time they played Buff State, it was quite an offensive showing. So it'll be interesting to see if they can replicate that kind of success. Both teams battle for this one. And Potsdam will escape and try to take this one in the offensive zone. But nice play from the Cards, able to maintain control of it as Unsworth. Play was tipped back. And now here come the Bears as Merrill takes a shot, same made by Nice. As I say, with Colleen in front of her and got it right past Colleen. Nice having to make a nice shot there as Merrill on the bad pass takes this one all the way to that shot. Save made by Nice. Oh, what a stop from the junior netminder. Came across the pad and robbed Nice. Robbed Merrill as Merrill put another shot on the net. We're free to play. Wow, what a stop from the goalie. So 17:40 left. Cards now up to 44 shots. Man, this team averages a little over 45 shots, so I've already met that shot total with 17:40 left. Seema also averages about 5.1 goals per game. Had 8 yesterday, so we'll see if they can meet their quota, per se. As Stump trying to dance through the zone. Nice interception by Holmes, who puts a shot on net, went trickled past or across the crease. As now Stump with it, trying to chop this one past Holmes. Stump having to be a little bit of an infielder there, getting her glove on the puck. As now Emery trying to get past Holmes. What a shift there. So Stump sending this one up to Calhoun. Calhoun trying to take this one through the slot. Shot was blocked and went past into neutral. Stump coming on with speed will go back to the point, go back to her defender and McArdle. And now Wasik, long pass up that went off of Calhoun. Is Krosnick taking up with speed. Krosnick long shot. Borg couldn't get her stick on the rebound as Holmes sends this one across and off the boards. So McArdle over to Benjamin. Play this one up for Borg, who dumps this one all the way down. As Kotago with the steal shot, save made. And Zerflew able to get her glove and stop play there. So another opportunity for the hat trick, or to add on to her hat trick. She made the interception behind the net, just took it in front of Zerflew, who was able to lock it down with the pad. So the Cards' fourth unit heading on the ice tonight is Chaney, Whitney, and Hurd. So we're going back to the point, McArdle. Trying to get it over to Whitney, we'll dump it behind the boards. And now Whitney, back for Benjamin. As McArdle whiffed on it there. And we'll dump this down for Hurd. As Potsdam coming on with speed there, long pass was intercepted. Nice play from Hurd the first year. As this one will be played back. Cleary dances around with it and is able to try to get the pass through up to Teachout as the Cardinals got in the way of that one. Now McArdle coming on with speed as that one's put in front. Save made. Now Whitney going back to the point for Benjamin. Over for McArdle. McArdle long shot. Scores! Aaron McArdle leads the Cardinal defenseman in point as she netted a goal to secure the record. So Aaron McArdle is your new points leader for Plattsburgh State. So another exclamation point on his sensational collegiate career from the defenseman. It scored an absolutely wicked goal from on top of the slot as her teammates congratulate her on the bench. And see Katanka throws that puck into the bench. That's definitely one you want to keep. A huge accomplishment for Aaron McArdle, and what a season she's had playing an absolutely incredible amount of minutes. 5-4, 21 games, has 21 points, 18 assists coming into this one, and then obviously a 2-point night for her so far, scored that big goal. So history made here. As they're trying to get the right puck. We're trying to get a new puck as Katanka threw that one into the bench. So you witness history here as Aaron McArdle puts her name in the Plattsburgh State books. Now Krosnick taking this one over the line. Is that shot across? Quick shot and they score! What a pass from Krosnick as Ivy Borg nets home the one-timer. And the Cards scored 2 in under a minute. And now take over this one with a commanding 6-1 lead. What a pass there. Krosnick set this one from on the near red circle across to the other side of the crease. Ivy Borg skated it through as Unsworth comes on with speed here to the net and save made. That one went wide. So just getting called over the PA now. Aaron McArdle officially the all-time points leader for a defenseman. Like I said, exclamation point to an absolutely historic collegiate career from the grad student defender. And if you watch these games, well, she does have is having a sensational point season. She's been nothing short of incredible, just doing a lot of that dirty work that you expect a defenseman to do. So, and the recent goal for Bork, that is Bork's 12th of the season and 31st, or now she's tallied over 30 points. A rebound and loose in front, going back out to the point. Colleen coming out with a broken defense shot, and that one was stopped. See, the defense a little bit collapsed in front of the net. So now Holmes takes one over the line as Nice bats that one out. So Potsdam trying to respond to that two goals in a short period of time as Olshansky's pass went up to Martin. That one found the other side of that stump picking this one up. So Stump dance around with it. She'll go back to the point for Wasik. Wasik fakes the shot and goes down low as Calhoun came over to reciprocate it. She eyes her options. We'll go to Wasik on the other side. Wasik long shot. That one went wide. We know Kendall Wasik got an absolutely powerful shot. Cards up to 48 shots, so exceeded their goal average and shot average this year. And what a start to third period with a two-goal effort. Said Aaron McArdle, who is now the all-time points leader for any defenseman in Plattsburgh State women's history. This faceoff will come in the near red circle for the Cards. Whitney wins this one back, points for Dampier. Dampier will dump this one all the way down as Whitney gets to it first and will skate it back past the Wasik. A little bit of a bouncing puck there, went off of a stick. Dumpy dumps this one down low. Chaney battling down in the corner as it'll be heard from the other side. And now here comes Potsdam. Long shot there, saved by Nice. So a big shot from Burke, who came on the near side. Nice coming out of her net to make a glove stop. So this faceoff will come in the near red circle. Cards able to win that one. McArdle trying to come over here and pick it up. And now the both teams will battle down low in the corner. And now Whitney sends this one past her the intended target. And now her almost had an opportunity there. She made a nice interception through three Potsdam defenders. The puck was taken away from her. As Clark went down, Benjamin with a tight defense there, no penalty called. And now McArdle trying to push it through as she fell down. And now Chaney coming through the zone on the far side, puts on the brakes. She tried to go across there, play was intercepted. As a penalty will be called there. Looks like on Sierra Benjamin as Merrill was taken down. So Potsdam trying to just chip away at the 5-goal deficit and will now go to the power play. Sierra Benjamin, call most likely be tripping. So 11:53 remaining. And Platts having to go to the kill. Whitney taking the faceoff against Stella Neve. And McArdle will get the clear right off the faceoff. This is what I mean about McArdle, just so sensational defensively as Boric chases after this one first as she was tied up on the play. That'll be sent past Potsdam. McArdle will get to it first. She looks for the crew, will play this one off the glass, sends it all the way down. Nice little play there from the defender. As Zerflew will field it back down for Banas. Borg able to intercept that, trying to take it to the net. Borg with room shot, save made by Zerflew. So Borg, good short-handed effort. Now the Cards having some zone time here as Killeen. We'll send it back down for Whitney, who went back to the point. Borg tied up, trying to get out of the zone. And now Potsdam controls. So Banas will skate this one behind the net. McArdle trying to tie her up in the corner. As Killeen, nice play there. Able to escape out of it. Her pass is blocked. As Borg will be able to send this one back into Potsdam's zone with 52 seconds remaining on the Benjamin penalty. Shot the side of the glass. As another penalty called there on the Cards. Going to be sent around. So extra attacker on for the Bears as Calhoun will be able to get a stick on the puck. So Plattsburgh penalty to kill this year. Only allowed 8 goals on 69 attempts as Plattsburgh's top defensive pairing, both in the box, Benjamin and McArdle. So 35 seconds remaining on the Benjamin penalty, and then McArdle's penalty coming at the 10:28 mark. So they'll have 5-on-3 for 35 seconds. Plattsburgh's kill this year is only allowed 8 goals on 69 attempts, 91.8%. That is a phenomenal penalty kill. And they'll be put to the test here, down 5-on-3. It was a bad play there from Cleary. Not able to keep in the zone. They'll have to clear it. They'll have to take it out into the neutral ice with 25 seconds remaining on the Benjamin penalty. Eye checking ends up being the call here. Is back on the other side. Quick shot, and that was blocked by Wasik. The attempted pass went wide. So now another shot there. Was blocked by Wasik. Rebound loose. It'll go back in front. As Merrill, as Benjamin heads back on the ice, so 1:23 remaining. As Katanka heads on the ice, the fourth person on the kill, as they find the back of the net there, so McArdle heading back as a power play goal for Potsdam. It was Megan Teachout who looked like she got the backhand bass knees. Knees did not look happy with that one. So we back to 5-on-5 play here as the Bears chipping away at this one, currently down 6-2. That is Teachout's fifth of the season. As Potsdam calls a timeout, now we really got to look whether or not they're going to try to find a set play to get back into this one. The two goals so far, and really the big storyline from today is Aaron McArdle setting the point record for any defenseman in Plattsburgh State history. As both teams trying to discuss. As for Potsdam, I think it's just try to set some kind of strategy here. You got to score 4 goals in a very short amount of time.
Potsdam goal, the 5th goal of the season, scored by number 3, Megan Teachout, assisting on the goal, number 15, Stephanie Gutland.
So both teams discussing what the plan is here, as Potsdam able to get their first goal since the first period. Megan Teachout, Cards struck twice in this period. The first by Aaron McArdle, and the second by Ivy Borg, both coming in very short sequence. So the Cardinals' second unit will take the ice here with 9:42 left. Potsdam coming off a timeout, obviously trying to get something going offensively, or just have not had much to work with. Really, 20 shots for them so far, which is pretty solid. The Cardinals only allow about 21.76 per shots on average. So met that quota too, is Cardinals controlling, or about to meet that quota, is Cardinals controlling off the faceoff. Wasik will take this one down. So we'll see for the Cardinals, their coach Houle's strategy was simply just run the clock and don't do anything aggressive or stupid, and just hold on to the puck and just try to pull on the puck and waste time as Unsworth trying to take this one to the net, looking for the centering pass, and Cardinals still obviously coming out with fire, trying to score. His long shot from Emery was tipped by Olshansky, who could not get the good bounce, as Potsdam will clear this one out and send it all the way down as icing will be called with just over 9 minutes remaining. So 6-2 Cardinals lead. With 9:01 remaining. 49 shots for the Cardinals, so very impressive. Shot count is Olshansky off the faceoff. Shot save made. Cardinals trying to bat home the rebound. Drew Mead came out with space. Nice play from Olshansky. Trying to make a beautiful shot. This play will be sent in the Cardinals zone. McArdle will get to it first. So the new points leader for defenseman in Plattsburgh State history takes this one all the way into the Potsdam zone. As another penalty will be called there. Play will be whistled down here. It'll be Potsdam heading to the box. Cardinals up to 50 shots. And now Plattsburgh will play up a man here. So after that timeout, Potsdam was trying to get something going, obviously, judging by their decision to call a timeout. So from Carly Green getting called the penalty on the body check, he came from behind the net as Norton. Kolasik on the other side. Cardinals power play at just over 30%, which is another phenomenal number for this team as Drew Mead. Went back to the point for Wasik. Wasik long shot was blocked as Olshansky was taken out. Drew Mead able to get her stick on the clear and keep it in the zone for the Cardinals. So Wasik on the other side for Norton. Back over to Wasik, slowing things down. Another long shot. Save made by Zerflew. And now Drew Mead with it again. Going over to Unsworth. Unsworth back over to Wasik. Then Drew Mead coming out of the net here. Trying to make the shot through. Unsworth picking up the rebound. Could not find it in the back of the net, so it'll be Drew Mead again. 1:18 remaining on the power play for the Cards is Wasik. Over to Drew Mead. Drew Mead shot! And Olshansky got her stick on it. Just could not redirect it there. It's Wasik long play. Olshansky again tipped that one, and it went wide. Both teams digging at it in the corner. Unsworth coming out with the steal. Skating it into the slot. Tried to make the shot. Could not get it to the net. With 51 seconds remaining on the penalty. So 49 seconds left to kill Potsdam, who have rented a goal so far, but allowed another lot of shots like that one there as that'll head into the netting. As Olshansky down on that play. So 43 seconds left of kill for Potsdam as the Cardinals sending out their big line, trying to get the goal here with under a minute left. It'll be Katanka taking this faceoff against Delaneve. And Potsdam escapes with it. Delaneve pinning this one up in the corner. Both teams dig for it on that far side. And now play will be whistled down. So an effective method there for Potsdam, who ran almost 20 seconds off the clock. That's 27 seconds remaining on the kill for them. Potsdam penalty kill going into this game just about 70% on the dot as McArdle. Back over to Benjamin. Going up to the top for McArdle. McArdle long shot. That one went wide as Boric sending it over to Krosnick. Krosnick back over to Boric. That's the top for McArdle. Over to Boric again. Boric skating on with speed. Shot and save made. Boric is lethal when it comes to plays like that where she can come out of the net, and we know how well she shoots and put it on test there and just not able to get the back of the net. We saw a nice goal from her earlier in the period where she skated on a Krosnick pass, skated through, and was able to rip the one-timer home. So when it comes to plays where she has room between her and the net, she is someone to definitely keep an eye on. So 5 seconds remaining of up a man hockey for the Cardinals as McArdle on the other side for Bender trying to get one more shot, and they do, and glove down by Zerflew. So the green penalty expires. It'll be back to 5-on-5 with 6:33 left. Cards leading 6-2. Now up to 53 shots. So have really peppered Zerflew, who's now allowed 14 goals this weekend as McArdle's shot is blocked. first play down whistle will be called. So it'll be an icing call here as the Cards will take the face off in Potsdam zone. It'll be Whitney taking it, Cards with the fourth unit out there. Face off against Teachout, it'll be back to point. So Dompier on the other side for Wasik, going down low for Hurd. And now here comes Potsdam, past the other side, attended for Green. Chaney using the body to layer out. No whistle blowing there. So now Chaney on the other side for Hurd, staying onside. Hurd shot, tipped by Chaney, finds the back of the net for goal. So what a sequence between Chaney and Hurd as a long pass played off the stick and into the net as Tatum Chaney, her third goal of the season and fourth of her career, the junior, puts the nail in the coffin as the Cards leading 7-2 with 5:54 remaining. And that one hurts if you're a Bears fan. As the Cards' third unit, their first-year line of Martin, Calhoun, and Stum on the ice. All three in their first season. That puck got past Plattsburgh defense and will go all the way down. Wasik gets to it first with 5:36 remaining. Tess Hurd being tied with this. That's a really nice pass from her. Only playing in her fifth game of the season, first year. It'll be interesting to see how her career pans out as a Cardinal, a Stump. Nice move past the defense. We'll take this one to her through as Martin long shot was blocked in front. Potsdam able to get it out. As this one sent across. Can be played behind the net. Potsdam controls with 5 minutes remaining here. As Wasik going back for Stum. Went off of Martin's stick all the way down. Pass going to the other side. And Colleen able to make the interception. And she'll play this one off the glass. Plattsburgh under 5 minutes remaining for another win here as Drew Mead trying to get over to Udsworth. Shot and save made by Zerflu. The play will be whistled down here, getting a little chippy here between both teams near the net. So Plattsburgh 18-2-1 this year and 13-0-1 in conference, looking for another conference win. Already have locked up the number one spot. Like I mentioned earlier, their fourth straight year winning the Newell, and the only team to ever win the Newell is a team that's only been around for 4 years, as Bolshanty dumps this one all the way behind the net. Drew Mead gets to it first. Keeping her eyes up, goes back to the point for Colleen. She goes down low again for Drew Mead, and Colleen with a good effort to keep it in the zone. Potsdam able to get to this one first. This teach out. Skates this one up the far side. Cardinals able to get their stick in the way. Now clean to it first. On the other side for Unsworth. Unsworth, dance pass defense shot and save made there. So it'll be Unsworth again. Nice move there, takes it to the slot. Keeps skating with it. We know she's an incredible skater and very good at keeping the puck on her stick as Norton shot and save made. Drew made able to chase after the rebound is. Unsworth heads for a change. Good play from Norton to keep it in the zone. Now both teams battling on those far boards. It'll be whistled down here. Looks like a penalty will be coming against Potsdam. So not what you needed here. Down five with 3:29 left in the game. Penalty comes against Emily Burke. So the card is getting another opportunity here to strike again with 3:29 left. Whitney will be taking this face off for the Cards. As Whitney on the other side for Emery. Emery shot. Nice block with the skate from Delaney. So Emery will chase this one back near the line. Over to McArdle. Back over to Emery. On the other side for Whitney. Whitney coming on. Shot went wide. So it'll be played on the near corner. McArdle again. Over to Emery. Back to McArdle. And then Emery with it again. On that far side, we'll go back to the point. McArdle coming on with speed. Play went behind the glass and played off the back glass. Both teams battling for it. And now Hurd on the other side for Emery. Log shot. Save was made. Rebound is loose. Carter's not able to get it home again. So Mac Emery, the extra defenseman today, really putting on a shooting showing here. She gets to the bench, able to put on quite a few shots in that last possession as 2:23 remains in the game, 53 seconds left on the penalty. This puck will be dumped all the way down. McArdle gets to it first. Play it up for Stumm. Stumm coming through the zone here. She's got heavy guarding against her, but keeps her head up. Stumm in front, shot! Looks like play was tipped down as Stumm lays out Holmes in the corner with 28 seconds left on the power play for the Cards as Martin escapes with it. As Wasik was coming on to make the shot and faked it out, she put a wrister on there. Save was made with 1:43 left in the game and 14 seconds left on the power play for the Cards. Cardinals third unit trying to get something going here. So it's going to be played out. Stumm trying to maintain control as penalty expires. So Potsdam with another kill today. As both teams getting chippy with it in that far corner. And Potsdam evades out with the puck. As Birch sends this one all the way down. Now coming on with speed here, quick shot, save made. So Alexis Clark coming on trying to get tally one here. And the save was made by Nice. So Nice, who has now made 20 stops today. And like we said, not a player gets a lot of consistent playing time and has played extremely well in this one. So 1:08 remaining in the game. Cards leading 7-2 over the Potsdam Bears and looking for a huge win here. As Whitney take this face off back. Whitney trying to get this one out. Nice play by Hurd getting her stick on the potential pass. And now under a minute remaining as Hurd coming up the ice. Going to get the shot through. Seeing Hurd make a lethal pass to Cheney for the seventh goal in a similar possession there. Could not get the shot through as the Cards up to 60 shots today. As Whitney over to Cheney. Cheney dances past the defense. Coming out with speed and saves made. So nice play there from the junior. As Cards still control with just under 30 seconds remaining. He sent back down low for Cheney. And then Colleen mishandles the puck and go back into neutral ice with 20 seconds left. So Colleen over to Emery. Emery coming on with speed here. Both teams battle for it on that near side. Back to Launigo for Cheney. Whitney's shot trickled across the crease. And Potsdam will clear it out as time expires. So the Plattsburgh State Cardinals end the weekend with a sweep over the Potsdam Bears. Tonight was 7-2. And what a offensive performance tonight. The Cards tallying 62 shots compared to just 22 from Potsdam, and 8 goals tonight. So the hat trick from Annie Katanka, May Olshansky tallied one of her own, and then the other ones came from Ivy Boric in the third, and then Aaron McArdle with a historic goal to put her in the all-time point leader of any defenseman ever to play at Plattsburgh State. So an incredibly historic night for Aaron, congrats. And the last goal came from Tatum Cheney for the 7 tonight. As for Potsdam, moved down to 8-13-1 with a 6-9-1 conference record, and have had a lot of trouble picking up wins as they came in this week on the 4-game win streak and just got absolutely destroyed by the Cards, losing by over 5 goals in both contests. So that puts them in a little bit of a scary position, trying to hang on to that last playoff spot and try to make it back. But the Cardinals, after last night, successfully clinched number one spot in the Newell. So their big season continues as they try to make a push for the national championship, and it starts with the playoffs that start soon. But for the Cards, they will go on to play Canton on Tuesday, and then their final two games will come this weekend here at the Ronald D. Savarese Arena against Buffalo State. The other big story from tonight is goaltending. Lila Neese taking the net for the Cards and comes up with over 20 saves, so a solid performance from her. And then Ellie Zinflu for Potsdam having another solid night while allowing seven, was kind of left out to dry by her defense, but came up big. So another big win for the Cardinals, who, when it comes to national rankings, these wins mean more than anything. So we'll see where they rank on Monday's Division III poll. But from the Ronald B. Stafford-Ace Arena, Cardinals pick up another win. Thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next time. I'm Liam Sample, and have a good one.
What an absolutely incredible game from the Cardinals as they beat the Potsdam Bears 7-2. We've got a lot to talk about, but first things first, the Cardinals came out to play back-to-back nights. Last night, they were able to take the big win against Potsdam, and they finished the job tonight, sweeping the two-game weekend series, as today they managed to outshoot the Bears three times over as the final was 63-21. Stories of the game here. We'll pick it up in the first period as Annie Katanka finds the back of the net for the early score. She would have plenty to do this game as the Cardinals went up with that early 1-0 lead. Just an absolutely incredible performance just to start the game, and Plattsburgh did not look back as they kept scoring. We'll pick it up later in the second period after the Cardinals already have a 3-1 lead, and let's take a look. Right now, it's Katanka again who gets the pass and finds the back of the net. Once again, folks, that would be her third score of the game for the hat trick there, as just an incredible performance from the captain, who has been a thorn in the side of Potsdam all three games they've played this season now. Finally, though, we'll go to the third period, as it would be a story of the captains today, as other Plattsburgh captain Aaron McArdle would do this. Passed around in the Potsdam and their offensive zone as McArdle finds the back of the net from out wide. As with that goal, she set a school record for most goals scored by a defenseman. Just an absolutely incredible performance from both the captains, and one for the record books there for Aaron. Moving forward for this, the Cardinals come out of this weekend series now with a 14-0-1 record in recent play, as they have continued to be on a roll here, moving closer to the playoffs, as they also grow their all-time record against Potsdam to 33-0. Just an absolutely impressive showing by the Cardinals as they continue to dominate this opponent and continue to dominate through the entire season, hoping to see more performances like this come playoff time, as this team has just been unstoppable. Hoping to give some good last rides to Annie Katanka, who once again just played absolutely incredible this entire game, and the teammates with her. Anyways, that'll wrap it up from the studio here in Plattsburgh. For PSTV, I'm Jeffrey Koff. Go Cardinals.